Hi, my name is Bob Sewell. The purpose of this video is simply to explain the very common problem known as gastroesophageal reflux disease, or GERD. Whenever you eat or drink anything, the food that you swallow goes from the back of the throat into the stomach through a long muscular tube called the esophagus. The stomach makes a highly concentrated form of acid that is protected from going into the esophagus by a sphincter. This sphincter relaxes whenever you swallow, allowing food to go through, but the rest of the time it stays closed. This is a protective mechanism. Whenever you belch, the gas makes its way back up through a relaxing sphincter, but if that sphincter stays open all the time, the esophagus will become injured and inflamed. The symptoms are heartburn. We usually call this, though more accurately, reflux esophagitis. For some people, frequent reflux of stomach contents in the esophagus causes other problems beyond just heartburn. This is a partial list of the GERD symptoms. It includes chest pain, especially after meals, or regurgitation of food and trouble swallowing, chronic cough or difficulty sleeping, frequent bouts of bronchitis or even aspiration pneumonia. Some patients have chronic laryngitis or asthma, while others have chronic sinus infections or dental problems. Even chronic bad breath can all be related to GERD. If left unchecked, chronic reflux can lead to even more serious problems, and in particular, the problem of esophageal scarring that leads to strictures that may even need to be dilated periodically. Ulcers can also develop in the esophagus that can lead to bleeding. And there's a condition known as Barrett's esophagus, which is a pre-malignant type of problem that is related to chronic gastroesophageal reflux disease. Some patients with symptoms of reflux also have a condition called hiatal hernia. The normal opening in the diaphragm can be stretched, allowing the stomach to push up into the chest. And when this happens, the valve at the bottom of the esophagus simply cannot work properly, which in turn then causes symptoms of reflux. At least 25% of patients with gastroesophageal reflux disease actually have a significant hiatal hernia that contributes to their symptoms. Many people with symptoms of hiatal hernia are successfully treated with medication, but if their symptoms persist, a laparoscopic operation to pull the stomach back down into the abdomen and close the hole in the diaphragm may be the best treatment option. Whenever GERD is suspected, based on any of the various symptoms that I've mentioned, tests are used to confirm the diagnosis, and the most common of these is upper GI endoscopy. With this test, we can assess the inside of the esophagus looking for inflammation, also can evaluate the presence and size of any hiatal hernia, the presence of any strictures or Barrett's esophagus, and also look for any other problems like gastritis, ulcers, or even tumors in the esophagus or stomach. Other tests are also sometimes helpful for confirming the diagnosis. Esophageal motility studies can be used to measure the function of the esophagus and the valve. A 24-hour pH study can be used to determine just exactly how often and how much acid is present in the esophagus. And an upper GI X-ray study can help define the size and location of a hiatal hernia or a stricture. Well, once the diagnosis of GERD has been made, the first thing your doctor will usually recommend is lifestyle change, including losing weight, avoiding overeating, avoiding spicy or fatty foods, avoiding certain chemicals like caffeine and nicotine or alcohol, and even peppermint, all of which can relax the lower esophageal sphincter. Elevating the head of the bed and avoiding lying down after eating can help avoid nighttime symptoms. These adjustments in lifestyle can certainly help, and they often do, but they're frequently insufficient to control the symptoms entirely. So most people end up taking some type of medication. Well, there's a variety of medicines available over the counter, including antacids and other stomach aids. Even some of the medications that used to be available only by prescription are now available over the counter. The prescription drugs that are most frequently recommended include the H2 blockers, but also the proton pump inhibitors. This is kind of the mainstay of current medical therapy. Medications offer some major advantages, but also they have some drawbacks. They're easy to use, they stop the heartburn in most cases, and they're relatively low risk. However, they require a lifetime commitment, and eventually they can lose their effectiveness. It's also important to know that they don't actually stop reflux. Nevertheless, simple heartburn can usually be controlled with medication. But for some people, they experience what we refer to as breakthrough heartburn, either at night or during the day, despite having taken medication even up to twice a day. Still, other patients have non-acid-related symptoms of GERD, like frequent regurgitation of food or chronic coughing, or asthma or chest pain after eating. These symptoms simply don't respond to medication. Not surprisingly, some people just don't want to take medication for the rest of their life, no matter how well they work. And for any of these reasons, some patients may be better managed with a minimally invasive surgical treatment that can potentially fix their reflux problem. To learn more about the various minimally invasive options available for treating GERD, click on one of the links at the end of this video. Thank you for watching this presentation on GERD, and if you have questions, please email them to info@robertsewellmd.com or call my office at 817-748-0200. My staff will be happy to set up a personal consultation appointment for you. Thank you.